This course is brought to you by Appy Pie as part of our Academy series.
So before I mentioned with these lean principles, how important it is to talk to your customers first. And in this video, I want to talk more about that. So why do you want to talk to your customers in the first place? And the reason is you will know exactly what problems they are facing. And this seems like such an obvious point, but still most entrepreneurs don't spend enough time talking to their potential customers. And if you do this, you're going to set yourself apart from so many other people that are trying to start businesses. Another reason to talk to your customers is you won't waste time on wrong assumptions. So I love this idea that we all see the world differently, and it's so true. So if you think that everyone has this single problem, that's from your perspective, and your customers are coming from a completely different perspective. So an idea that seems so right in your head that it's so obvious that other people want it actually might be something that nobody else really wants. And that's why the best way to find out if your customers really have this problem that you're thinking about is to ask them directly. And in this sense, you won't waste time building something based on your assumptions of what people want. You'll build something based on the source, your customers, telling you exactly what they want. Another great reason to talk to your customers is you'll have an infinite amount of ideas that you can turn into successful businesses. You will be surprised by how many problems people have that you can find a way to solve, and they will pay you for it. Once you catch on to this idea, it's incredible how many business opportunities are out there. So let's say you don't have a potential type of customer yet. So you want to start from scratch. Well, you can start by writing a list of people you know that you think will likely be willing to talk to you for 15 or 20 minutes. And a great way to do this is just get an Excel document and write someone's name, a person that you know, and their phone number. And then you can either give them a quick call or send them a quick email message asking them if they're willing to talk to you for about 15 minutes just about their problems, and you can tell them that you're looking for problems to solve. And the thing is, interviewing is a skill, and in order to develop the skill, it's going to take practice. So when you first start doing these customer interviews, it's probably going to feel really awkward, and you might not have the timing down so great. And that's okay. That's part of the process. And your first interviews may be really messy, and you may not get a lot of great information out of them, but the more you do this, the better you'll become. And once you get really good at interviewing other people, you're going to notice a tremendous difference in the type of answers you get and how many problems that you find that you can solve. So the two main aspects to being a great interviewer are asking the right questions and listening carefully. And whenever you're interviewing, especially when you're just starting out, it's really important that you record your calls. And that's because by listening to your calls once you finish them, you will get better because you will get to see what things you did right in the interview, what things you could have done better, and then change that for the next interview. Now, one important note is whenever you record your call, you always want to tell people up front that their call is being recorded.